All right, dude.
Hello.
How are you?
Very good.
Nice to see you.
Sunburnt from our exploits yesterday.
I nearly messaged you yesterday, like, how sunburnt are you? Because I was sunburnt, and I don't really burn.
I was so burnt from my photo shoot.
Yeah.
So watch out for me in Cyclist magazine with massive red arms.
They might be able to Photoshop it.
Why have you got your tiny camera? You're taking this ride seriously?
I'm taking this ride seriously.
We've actually got to try.
I'm going to train.
Shit. Today. Right, we're going that way. Doing 4 hours, 4.5 hours with some race efforts.
So they call it vlogception?
Well, that's a banned word. You're not allowed to say
that. I didn't know.
That's a very small fluff you got.
I know. He's just got like a little punk haircut, doesn't he?
Yeah, it's nice.
It's not as nice as like
you know,
big grown up one, daddy one.
So Rob's got a few intervals to do today. He's doing a bit of race simulation. He's got 3 15-minute efforts. He's basically going to start off 5 minutes sweet spot, then 5 minutes at threshold, and then the last bit alternate between zone six and easy for 30 seconds each time. It's kind of the effort you do at the end of a race, and as the season is in full swing, that's the sort of training he's got to be doing. If we get a chance to stop, I'll ask him all about it. But for now, we're plugging away. I love cycling.
Cycling's so fun.
So much. Just invented a new type of interval. It's like cameraman intervals.
Just hearing Cat Francis fiddle around with his camera. Caught right beside you. Don't let this guy sandbag the threes and fours hitting.
Well, we're like halfway through the ride now. Second interval, going up this climb. Luckily, this is the sweet spot one, so hopefully it won't be as hard. And yeah, easy.
Easy.
No.
15 minutes again.
15 minutes, baby.
It's always great stuffing your face right before an effort as well.
Yeah, well, better than bonking.
It is better than bonking.
These are easy to get down. OT, anytime, bro. Yeah, man, I'm...
How are you going to hear my shouts of encouragement?
I'm not, and that's the point, because I don't need you shouting at me while you're filming me, while I'm suffering. But no, I mean, it's always good to get the bit of Billy Ray Cyrus remix. Little Nas. Gonna take my horse to the old town road. Gonna. Nah, it goes on. Might put the remix of Green Shirt. Was it Dave?
You mean Green Shirt Grant?
Green Shirt Grant. It was
Green Shirt Bay.
I got the horses in the bag. Horse stock is attached. Head is matted black. Got the boosters black.
Yeah, well, fun.
Yeah, that was tasty, man.
We ran out of road.
Yeah.
Too quick.
That's a U-turn.
That's the problem with the Surrey Hills. It's difficult to find a steady effort.
It's hard to do a long effort. Great roads, but not ideal for an extended kind of interval. But we made it work.
It's not always a bad thing, I guess, because if you're, I mean, in a race, when do you get a perfect smooth effort? You need to learn to pedal on the downhills, right?
I mean, when you're racing, you're not doing it on a perfect 4% gradient for X amount of minutes.
Nah.
So it's quite race-specific, really, because you're going up and down corners. Steep inclines, shallow inclines, descents.
Not bad at all.
It's really good.
This is the aero vlog.
Aero vlog.
Yeah.
Efficiency.
Right, last interval of the day coming up. Another 15 minutes, but this one's got the dirty bits at the end. Wish me luck.
Last interval of the session coming up. Sun's out, legs feel good. Francis is still hanging in there with his camera. And we'll try and break him this time. We're here for it.
Yeah. Great.
Job done. Thank fuck for that.
Yeah, I'd reckon I hit the Giro.
Oh yeah, got three more hours of chamois time in Giro, mate.
Yeah. I go for four today. I wore sunscreen today, so I can sit in the sun longer.
Travel stop.
Yeah, fair enough.
Hey man.
You back?
Yeah.
What's going on, mate? Did you survive?
Looking good.
What do you got there?
Kevin.
Oh, Kevin.
That's a nice frame.
Yeah.
And that is a nice wrap.
Full of meat.
Hey, don't look at my lunch.
Is it bad for you? Oh no!
I managed to save her from the hair.
Do you want some peanut butter loaf?
Yeah.
Saved it.
Like this one.
Please don't eat it! Oh my god, it fell on the floor.
Ooh.
So we've just ridden 4 hours,
yep.
Done three sets of intervals. Some of it was sweet spot, some of it wasn't. Why is this one of your favorite training sessions? And what exactly are you training when you do intervals like that?
It was a little bit of like a race simulation style day. So, you know, 4.5 hours on the pedals, even outside of the efforts. And then the main idea was to stroke the aerobic engines. So that's why you got like the 10 minutes of basically sweet spot slash threshold before the anaerobic stuff. And that's more of a race simulation stuff, the on off. Repeatability and doing that under fatigue too, so a bit of the fatigue resistance kind of thing too. It kind of replicates what you're going to be doing in a real life race instead of doing like a perfect effort on like we spoke about earlier, like a perfect bit of road. And then the sweet spot in the middle was just again just get more time in that aerobic zone. So it was really more of a threshold day, like to stroke that engine. But I don't do a lot of it. I do more of a polarized training normally, but it is important every now and then to go back to the zone 3 threshold aerobic stuff and just make sure I stay on top of it. Some people do a lot of it, some people don't do a lot of it at all. I probably don't do a lot of it at all, but I like to go back and visit it like at least every once every 10 days to 2 weeks.
Is it important to do the sort of efforts that we did today within a longer ride, like a 4-hour ride, to get the volume as well? Or can someone just do those efforts isolated?
No, you could absolutely do it isolated. And I mean, if you're a bit more time crunched, for instance, you'd do it probably isolated because you don't have 4.5 hours to go and ride. But for me, it's good to get like a couple hours in the legs first. Like ideally you get to burning around like 2,000-2,500 calories and then start racking the efforts up. Today we didn't quite do that because where we're doing the efforts is kind of like not far enough away, and then it's too far from home to do it, if you know what I mean. But if you lived like at the bottom of a climb, you'd nearly go and do them all in the back end of the ride to make it a bit more race specific. If you don't have the time, you absolutely could do these efforts just stand alone. And like some of the guys I coach, I do assign them stuff like that all the time. Obviously being a full-time cyclist and a pro cyclist, it's a bit of a luxury that you have that time to train. So I think, yeah, absolutely.
Well, I think it's recovery time now.
Yeah, definitely recovery time now, man.
Might get another burrito.
Another burrito?
No. Might get a tubolito.
A tubolito? Maybe a tubolito in the burrito.
Yeah.
I reckon you should invent a recipe for a burrito at Giro, and it should be called the tubolito. Then, boom.
Marketing genius.
Yeah.
25 seconds on the road. At the moment, it's one man holding off three behind.
It's not very nice.
Not too far behind though, the rest of it. Bruno's just going to try and follow.
The bike packing wall.
You can't see it.
The black one is not better.
The black one's better.
That's
yeah.
Cool.
I'm going to get a black one. You can't see it. We've got hip flask holder, drone parking, camouflage.
Yeah.
I reckon you fit 6 cans of ale in there. Kindling for starting a fire in the woods when you're lost on an adventure. Busy bike.
Tubolitos.
Tubolito, you'd get about 17 tubolitos in there.
You could even fit a pro bike tool, multi-tools.
Yeah, and some OT anytime bars.
Yeah.
If you got really stuck, you could wear it as a hat. If you're like out in the desert.
You've got an enormous head.
Is it unisex? You can try it on.
Yeah, it's
definitely
unisex.
Does it fit my head?
It's
because it's
nice, yeah.
Size men only.
Like maybe just be better as a drone car park than a hat. But
yeah, I'll take one of those. Boom, bike packing sorted.
Living in the future with the new bike packing setup.
Pack light.
One lunchbox.
Yeah, you put your hotel key card in there. That's proper bike packing.
Guys who win the TCR stay in hotels.
Apparently so.
Pack light, sleep properly, yeah. And then you can race better the next day.
And this one,
not
this,
that I'm going to be winning the TCR.
Here's the thing though. I think that bike packing shouldn't be a race. You know,
an experience.
Get from one point to the next point.
Adventure.
And a nice slow speed. Enjoy it. A few of these at night and just enjoy the road, you know. Proper roadman bike packing.
I'm bike packing with you, mate.
You're coming bike packing me?
Can we spoon at night?
No.
We just should.
No.